Hey everyone, and welcome. Are you tired of manually inputting data into Google Sheets? Do you wish there was an easier way to create powerful data entry forms without deep coding knowledge? Well, today I'm going to show you exactly how to create a Google Sheets data entry form using generative AI, making this process easier than ever before. Thanks to generative AI tools like Gemini or ChatGPT, building web apps with Google Apps Script and Google Sheets has become streamlined. Even if you have limited coding experience, you can now build powerful tools for data management. By the end of this video, you'll know how to create, deploy, and share your very own data entry form. Let's dive in. The first and most crucial step is writing an effective prompt for your generative AI. Think of it as clearly explaining your requirements in simple English. Here's an example of a prompt we'll use. You'll want to break your request down into four main parts: the big picture goal, the details of the form, what happens after submission, and finally, the specific instructions you need. First, state the overall objective clearly. You'd say, "I want to make a Google Apps Script web app that I can use to fill in product details and save them into my Google Sheet." This gives the AI the core context right away. Next, describe exactly what the user will see and interact with. Break it down field by field. The form should have a box to type the product name, a drop-down list for product category with these options: electronic, kitchen appliances, bedroom furniture, living room furniture, a box to enter the quantity, only numbers, a box to enter the unit price in dollars, a box to type remarks. Right after that, you specify the behind-the-scenes part. Say, "I also want the sheet to have a column for the date and time the entry was added. This should be added automatically when I submit the form. And when I submit the form, it should save the data to the sheet, show me a message that it worked, and then clear the form so I can add the next one." Now add the styling request. Please make the form look nice using Bootstrap. Finally, be very clear about what you need the AI to give you. This ensures you get a complete, usable solution. Give me all the code I need: HTML, Bootstrap, and Apps Script, and also clear steps for creating the Google Sheet, adding the code, publishing the web app so I can open it and fill out the form, and how to share it with the data entry staff.
Once you have your prompt ready, simply paste it into a generative AI tool like Gemini or ChatGPT. I'll use Gemini's Canvas tool to generate code.
The AI will then generate all the necessary code and instructions for you. You'll typically get two main files: code.js for server-side functions and index.html for the user interface. The Gemini Canvas will also provide a live preview of this user interface. Let's get our sheet ready. If you go to the instructions, you will find the set of headers for our Google Sheets data table. Let's go ahead and copy them to set up our Google Sheet. Now simply open a new Google Sheet and add the copied headers into the first row. These headings should match your form fields, including any auto-generated ones. If specific headers aren't provided, just use your form field names instead. Don't worry, you can always rearrange the column order later. You'll also find the name for your sheet inside the instruction section. Go ahead and copy the given name and use it to rename your sheet. If you can't find the name there, you can also look for it inside the code.js file. Alright, with our sheet ready, let's add the code. First, head back to the AI's response and find the server-side code, which is usually in a file named code.js. Go ahead and copy that entire script. Next, jump back to your Google Sheet and open the script editor by going to Extensions, Apps Script. This will pop open in a new tab.
Rename the project.
Finally, just delete any default code you see in the editor and paste in the code you copied. Next, we need an HTML file for our form's interface. In the Apps Script editor, click the plus icon in the File tab, then select HTML from the dropdown. This will insert a new file, and you should name it Index.
make sure it exactly matches the name used in the code.js file.
Copy the code for the index.html file from the AI's output and replace any existing code in the index.html file you just created. Don't forget to save your project by clicking the floppy disk icon.
Now that our code is ready, it's time to deploy our project as a web app. In the App Script Editor, click on Deploy, New Deployment. Click on Select Type and choose Web App. Now let's configure the deployment. For a description, give it a name to identify this deployment. For Execute As, select me, your email address. For who has access, choose anyone. This allows anyone with the link to access the form. If you need more restricted access, you can choose anyone with Google account and configure it accordingly. Click the deploy button. The first time you deploy, you'll be prompted to authorize access. Click authorize access, select your Google account, and grant the necessary permissions. After successful deployment, you'll see a web app URL. Copy this URL. This is the direct link to your brand new data entry form.
It's time to test our form. Open the web app URL you just copied in your browser or simply click the provided link. Fill in some test data into the form fields. Submit the form. After you submit the form, you'll see it clear itself and display a success message, just as we planned. Now, head back to your Google Sheet. You should see your new data appear correctly in the next row, complete with the automatically added date and time. Now you've successfully created a Google Sheets data entry form using generative AI. This method truly streamlines the development process, letting you focus on functionality rather than getting stuck on intricate code. Now let's see how to modify the form again with the help of AI. Since we're using the Gemini Canvas tool, we only need to ask for the specific modifications. So let's ask the AI to add a new field for product color. Once you have the updated script, simply replace the entire contents of your code.js and index.html files with the newly generated code. This time, instead of choosing New Deployment, let's use the Test Deployment option. This is great for testing because it lets you see your changes just by refreshing the page without having to redeploy for every small modification. You'll see our new field has been added successfully. You also need to add a new column in your Google Sheet for this new field. Let's submit a record to see what happens. It looks like our new data isn't lining up with the correct columns. Instead of rearranging the columns in the Google Sheet, we can simply adjust the order the data is sent from our script. I'll just move the product color value to come right before the product category. Save the project. Since we are working with a test deployment, we can see the changes simply by refreshing the page. Now try submitting another record. You'll see the data is now inserted in the perfect order.
And there you have it. As you can see, using generative AI is a game changer for creating powerful web apps for Google Sheets. This approach doesn't just speed up the process, it empowers anyone, even with limited coding experience, to build incredible tools for managing data. To learn more, make sure to visit the blog post linked in the description. There you can copy the exact prompt we used and see a live example of this data entry form. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more tech tutorials, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss our next video. Thanks for watching.